Going live tonight for opening night, so we'll see how many. Give us some time, see who logs in. Taking a look at the games set for opening night. I think it looks like a Mudville at Manchester. Might as well grab the first game and get ready to kick that one off. And we've been waiting probably a week and a half, getting ready for opening night. We had the first league we set up and had a few, ended up simming that out, right? Because we got going first in the park is Beatles. Yes, yes, yes. And Beatles, you'll be glad to know, the very first game on the schedule is the one I'm going to play, and it's your Mudville with Pete Alexander going against Jason DeGrom in Manchester. That is going to kick it off. And we'll see if I have time to maybe get in a second game from April 10th. First in the park. I don't know if we have so many first in get bobbleheads tonight. Too bad we don't have a promotion like that. But oh well. See here, taking a look at drop my link here. Yeah, let me know what you mean by that. Beatles, like, whichever games I play, I can just name them. I guess I could name them for each game we played. Who knows? Or I could let me know what you mean by suggestion there. Yeah, it might be something like games from opening day, because my goal would be to, yeah, perfect. Yeah, exactly. I think that's the way too. That might be May 7th, and then the extension will automatically be like .bbx. So maybe it's just as simple as saying, like on this one, April 10th. Yeah, I think I'll use the game date. So my thought would be, as we go through and play these, how many, in other words, like tonight, maybe I'll play one, maybe two, if I've got time, off this first April 10th, and then I would sim the rest, and then zip those up and call them April 10th or whatever, and post them for whoever picks up next, whether that's MV or you. I think going forward, if I ended up, as a good example, if I ended up playing one, two, three, all four of these days that are listed here, all I'd have to do is zip up all of those four, and I could name it April 10, 11, 12, and 13, or April 10 to 13, something like that. I think it's probably smart that whoever hands it off, that we at least finish out a day. Probably makes it easier. So I'm going to grab my YouTube thing here. I'm looking, making sure I've got all my parks set up and all this good stuff. It will, because what it'll do, as long as we play them in order, that's where we're good. It will automatically pick the next people in the rotation for sure. So like today, I'll make sure that I finish out April 10th. I might play a couple games, and then I'll, if MV or you are here, I'll see who wants it next, and then maybe, we can't, I guess, take a year playing these, right? But maybe I'll take a, looks like we have the same. Well, we'll see how this thing switches up. Anyway, but it will automatically pick up the next pitchers. The only bad thing would be like, let's say somebody skipped ahead, then it would be a little bit confusing, right? So as long as the BBXs come in, it will, and we go day by day and make sure everything's accounted for, it'll be fine. So we got three people coming in here. I ran multiple this morning. I had a bunch of projects I had to do this afternoon, but this morning I ran, I think, six, and there was only one repeat champion that I had. Hey, Aaron, how are you? Welcome, welcome. Yeah, and I think, Beatles, the main thing we go is we'll just call it by the season. Like if I play April 10th and 11th, all the games tonight, let's say, then when I put the BBX front up, I'll just say April 10-11. And then we know that when whoever loads that file, it'll automatically be ready to go to the at the 12th. I think what we were doing is we might be playing one game on a particular day on the schedule, and then somebody would pick another one. I think whoever is simming just at least complete that entire date on the calendar so that each date is complete on those BBXs. Speaking of rotation, well, if let's do a little preview tonight. We're going to have Mudville at MV at Ebbets. So let's take a look at this Mudville team. Let's take a look at their saved lineups, and I'll notice oh nice so I notice you got it set the way you want it and everything. Ah, Mudville. Do I, I'm assuming you want me to take this off? Since all of, well, I guess it wouldn't matter advancing. It looks like it's advancing lineup to lineup, but it also looks like every one of your lineups the same, Beetle. So you have advanced next lineup after each game right here. And if even though it does look, if you look at this, every one of your lineups is the same. So I'm just throwing that out here. So if we look at, if you look at one versus left, oh, the other thing too, I'll default them. You can see the next ones that are coming up. I'll just make sure they go one and one. And if we go back and look at your lineup, I could loan up one versus left. Four versus left, and you'll notice they're all the same. So you're good to go. Yeah, I think you're good shape there. Pitchers, let's take a look at rotation. Yeah, Rob is good evening, Rob. How's it going? I think each team should use four or five man roster. I think each team has either four or five man rosters. Let's take a look. Jersey's got a five man. North Sound has a four. Badlands a five. Cleveland five. Hawaii five. Arlington five. I've got five. Des Moines 5, that's Rob's team, and Manchester 4. So yeah, it looks like everybody's running a five man except two teams are running four man rosters. Nice, nice, nice. So Mudville will be at Manchester. Now, I know MV has done a ton of tinkering, so let's take a look at this. Oh, I see what he's doing. He's got a four-man roster, and then he'll bring in Hecker, who is a jewel, but does not have a ton of innings pitched. And here he is. He only got 104 innings pitched. So Hecker will get, I've got the rule set up right here on usage that anybody that gets over 150%, they get smashed. In other words, they lose about half of their potential, which makes them horrible. So we can get 150% of real life, which is pretty liberal, and then they will be disastrous. I've got everything double checked. Thanks to Beatles, we've gone with the Howie Shanks logo we've got here. And I'll have to go back and take a look at those Beatles on the on your channel. So let's take a look at Manchester. Take a look at their save lineup so you can see. Let's see what he's got on here. Manager. Oh, yes. I can see he's changed some of his settings around here. And he won't advance lineup, so he'll be running. Versus lefties, this is his lineup here. Josh Gibson batting third. Versus righties, Chick Stahl comes in. I think I saw a video a couple days ago, maybe where MV was playing around with this. Dun, dun, dun. Only got a couple people here. I'll see if I'll just give it a couple of minutes and then we'll get going. Manchester is the home team. So, since if he shows up, Beatles, well, then I guess he gets dibs on making some of the basic calls. But until he shows up, you're here. So, guess what? If there's any kind of decision options that we get into, what is it we call it? The pink hand? Wave the pink hand, and you'll be able to maybe impact the game a little bit. So let me fire that up. We have Mudville. In Manchester. All right, Beatles. And let's see. See if it puts the right pitchers in. So we should be looking for Pete Alexander. And we got him. The opponent's rotation should be DeGrom. And it is. And it has loaded. DeGrom is a lefty. And there it is. So there's the versus lefty lineup that the Red Bolts want. And let's see what the computer lineup does. Let's go load lineup versus run. Beatles? The Grom is a righty. Interesting. Trying to see what's funky about this thing right here. Let me see. Just bear with me here a minute, gentlemen. I want to make sure at least we start off game one with the proper lineups in here. And now I don't have a DH in here, so. This is the one that should be in there.
Play ball.
Something was odd there. Yes. They did because they're down to 25. So checking, we're both at 25. All right. Let's try this again. Home, home, play. We've got DeGrom. Wonder why this isn't putting in. Oh, I got it. I'll have to start the game and exit out.
Play ball!
All right, so I'm going to make sure I didn't mess up the manager files and get them back in shape here. Got Manchester and Mudville. And I'm going to drop them in the bingo season. Hey MV, welcome, welcome, welcome. I think I was messing up stuff on your lineup, so I'm bringing in your latest cards because to kick it off, your manager files, I mean, it will be Beatles at you to kick things off. So I'm dropping them in here. And we'll see here, we'll have imports. Should be two manager files. There are. Manchester, Mudville, and we're good. Here we go. Scheduled league game. Home, home. We're gonna, or human, human. We're gonna play it. Alexander DeGrom. Just odd. Load up line. I don't think this is your right lineup, which is odd here. We're going to get the advance down. Reload. See that save lineup right there? This is the one. Odd. I cannot get this.
Play ball.
Me go into Mudville. I cannot get yours to come up here, Beetle. So. That's the one we should see. That's what we should see. So let me see if I put yours to computer. Yep, I am going to try this one. Keeps telling me that interesting. Let me go check the settings. Something is off. Well,
play ball.
here we go. I don't know why that one was checked. That box there got unchecked. That's causing an issue. Now, here we go. Okay, let's try this again. That is your proper lineup, MV. Now, if I should get, there we go. Oh my gosh. Hey, Legends. Now we got in the stuff that we needed. So a little note to those of you that maybe downloaded the file that I posted, don't use that one. I'll post a, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll post a new one after I play these games. That way, or you could go into the one MV or Beatles and just check that under rules to make sure DH is checked in League One. I don't know how that got unchecked. I must have been delirious one day or something. And here we go. We got a kickoff. Is it kickoff Sunday? Yeah, we'll call it. Let's get this baseball going. I can see if it's day or night because it's a night game. I'm going to get this field over here so I don't have to run into this again. Opening day, getting all this stuff set up. Oh, and here we go. So we are set. We're about ready to start the season. Yeah, no need for a new file, Beals. Just check that DH in League One. Same thing for UMV. For some reason, that was unchecked. And what it was doing is, because it was throwing the pitcher in the nine slot, it wasn't allowing your preset lineups to write over because they had a DH in them and the league didn't want it. So, hey, here we go. We are, get all my goodies here set up, and I can start focusing on this game. Bring the sound up a little bit. So our ambient noises here, have a little bit of fun with it. Any predictions for this wonderful game tonight? Uh-oh. Rob, congratulations. I have 14 of them little grandkids, so. Jason DeGrom on the mound. Wonderful day. 5-mile-an-hour wind left to right. Beautiful day at Ebbets. The Red Bolts looking to get off the season with the win. All of the... mad scientist work that their manager MV has been doing here in the last couple of weeks, testing everything. Let's see if it pays off. And Beatles finally has his lineup where he's got Cobb and Keeler in here. So this should be a fun one. And here's DeGrom with the opening pitch of the Shanks Bingo League. Oh, and we have a grounder. And DeGrom looks like he was going to take it himself, and this one will be an infield hit safe as Keeler beats that one out. So one batter, one aboard. Up to the plate, Ty Cobb. Keeler on first. This is that small ball, dead ball kind of baseball that no doubt Beatles loves. Oh, and it looks like Keeler was moving. Morgan has one play to first, gets Cobb, and Keeler takes second. So they had the hit and run going right there. Computer manager doing what Beatles intended. And batting in the three hole for Mudville is Pop Lloyd. the shortstop. Here's the pitch. Lloyd hits this one. It's out to right field. Stahl's drifting back, and this one is out of here. Kiss it goodbye. Out at right field at Ebbets, and we have a 2-0 ball game as DeGrom gives up the home run to Pop Lloyd here in the first inning of opening day. So I know this isn't going down the way MV would have scripted, but it's still early. Beatles definitely has some power, so let's take a look at this lineup. You got Keeler and Cobb. Pop Lloyd coming in. Now we're going to go with Fox, Ruth, and George Foster. And he's got Darrell Evans, the lefty third baseman, who had 41 homers on the season. So there's some power coming up now. Now here's Jimmy Fox, the first baseman. DeGrom with the pitch. And Fox sends this one out to left field. Ted Williams drifting back. And this one is in the stands. Those are back-to-back home runs from Pop Lloyd and Jimmy Fox. And it is a 3-0 ball game with Babe Ruth stepping up. MV must have saw something in DeGrom, who gets the opening day start for the Red Bolts. All the testing and preseason, some reason he felt this is the guy to start with. He might wish he could have that back, but we'll see. I haven't seen MV commenting yet. Oh, it's going to be a long night. There's the comment. Here's the pitch to Babe Ruth. DeGrom with the pitch. Ruth sends this one out to right field. Stahl back. I guess we won't get three in a row. And that's the second out of the inning. So we got two down. George Foster. This is based off that great 77 season. Left fielder for Mudville. And the pitch. And he gets him for the third out with a strikeout. And here comes the bottom of the first. See if MV's team can rally a little bit. And they've got Tommy Tucker leading off. And Chick Stahl batting second. Tucker's the first baseman today. To the pitch from Pete Alexander. And this one is lined into right field for a single. And Tucker's aboard. So just like Mudville, MV and the Manchester Red Bulls get their first runner on. And here's Chick Stahl. Tucker on first. And the pitch from Alexander. Ooh, he throws over, trying to keep Tucker close. And the pitch. And Stahl sends this one out into right field. Tucker's rounding second, and he's going to hold as Cobb gets that into Davey Johnson. We now have runners at first and second, no out. And here's where we can see some strength in the Manchester lineup with Ted Williams, who will be followed by Josh Gibson and Mike Schmidt. There's the pitch. Williams sends this one out to right field. Cobb makes the catch. Tucker will tag. There's a throw. And he gets him. Ty Cobb guns out Tucker, who was tagging up and trying to get to third. And I'm sure Coach MV is not going to be happy with that. And we have two down now. Josh Gibson stepping up. And he hits this one hard. And right in. Oh, it's going to be off the wall. Ruth couldn't get it. And that'll bring a run home. And Gibson trots into second with a double. So we've got a 3-1 ball game. And Mike Schmidt steps up. The pitch. Schmidt lines it into left. Ruth making the play. He's got the throw to the plate. Here's the throw. And he throws him out. Two base running outs made by the Red Bolts. Ty Cobb guns a runner at third. Ruth guns a runner at home. It could have been a tie game, but no. 3-1. Mudville. Yeah, MV's like, my God. They're running all over the place. Here's Darrell Evans. Left-handed third baseman steps in. And on the ground, Mike Schmidt over to Tucker, and he gets him in time. So here's Davey Johnson, second baseman. DeGrom pitches, and he strikes out Davey Johnson. That'll bring Yadier Molina up. Not much bat power from Molina, but he's had got great defense behind the plate. DeGrom with the pitch. Molina sends this one over. DeGrom will get to it in time, tosses to Tucker. And that's the third out. So after one and a half, it's 3-1. Mudville. Here's Elmer Smith stepping up. Let's take a peek at Elmer Smith. This is somebody I watched MV the other day. He thinks he's onto something here. Of course, MV usually does think he's onto something until he's not. But this is a player. It looks like he's tweaked this lineup. He's got Mantle batting eighth. He's got this against righties, this lefty, Elmer Smith, coming into DH. This is called this is a master class in tweaking your lineup. So we'll see how this plays out through the season for MV. And here's the pitch from Pete Alexander. And Smith pops this one up. Should stay in the infield. Davey Johnson looks like he's going to make an easy play. And he does. And we have one down for Joe Morgan, who in this new orchestrated lineup against righties bats seventh. I'm looking at this lineup, MV, saying, you know, when you, as a pitcher, when the 7, 8, 9 hitters come up, you can usually try to breathe a little. But you got Joe Morgan, Mickey Mantle, and A-Rod down there. It's quite a back end of the lineup. Here's the pitch to Joe Morgan. Oh, looks like they're coming in on the infield corners, afraid that Morgan might bunt. And he strikes out. And here's Mickey Mantle. Pitch from old Pete. And he strikes out and throws it down for the drop ball. And we'll get him in time for the out. So here's Keeler. He had a hit up his last time, and he leads off the third inning here, and he's on base again. Looks like a pretty good steal percentage over there. Cobb lines it out to right, and we've got another base running out as Keeler was hoofing it down to second, doesn't get back to first in time, and we have a double play. Base running leaves a lot to be desired tonight. Here's Pop Lloyd. Hit a two-run homer to right field in his last at-bat. Here's, grounds it back to DeGrom, who makes the easy play to Tucker, and the inning is over. No runs, one hit, no errors, and after two and a half, we have Mudville 3, Manchester 1. And here's the number 9 hitter, Alex Rodriguez, the shortstop. He's aboard with a single. I'm over here hitting C, and I realize I've got Q on, which is I can just hit Q and do the same thing. Here's another hit. Tucker, the leadoff hitter, sends this up through the middle. And Manchester, do we send Rodriguez to cert? Not with a save chance of 33. We've had enough damage on the base paths. That will be a no. Chick Stahl in against righties. The pitch from Alexander. Stahl hits this one. Foster's drifting way back. He'll make the catch. Send Rodriguez to third. Do we want a chance at MV? You tell me. What the heck? And he's in there safely. So we got runners at the corners, one out. Ted Williams up.
Ball four. Take your base.
And now we have them loaded. could there be a better person in the Red Bull lineup to come up with the bases loaded than Josh Gibson? The pitch. He sends this one into left field. Ruth's got it. Gets it in quick. One run scores. Base is still loaded. Mike Schmidt at the plate. Pitch to Schmidt. Schmidt lines this one. Ruth's got it again. In quickly. They're hitting them so hard, those runners don't have a chance to get home. We've got a tie ball game, folks. With only one out, bases loaded. Pitch by Alexander. And he strikes out Smith. That's a key strikeout right there. And up steps little Joe Morgan, the second baseman. The pitch. Morgan sends this one out into left field. It's a hit. Runner will score as he rounds third. That's Josh Gibson. And we've got four runs in this inning, and it's a 5-3 lead for the home team Red Bulls. Here's Mickey Mantle. Sends this one out to right field. Ty Cobb will make the out, but not before some serious damage is done that inning. And just like that, the hometown Red Bulls are in the lead. After three, a 5-3 Manchester lead. Not much of a pitcher's duel here in the opening day game. Pitch. Oh, Fox lines this one. He's aboard with a single. Poor play by Williams, but Fox will stay at first. And that's a base hit. Babe Ruth flew out his last time up. Steps in against DeGrom. Looking at the numbers over here, 10% chance of a home run. The pitch. And a strikeout. George Foster steps in. Pitch from DeGrom. This one's out to center. Mantle looks like he's tracking it down. He will make the catch. And we have two away for Darrell Evans, who grounded to third his last time up. The pitch. And there's the strikeout. Out of the inning they are. And it's still 5-3 Manchester. Pete Alexander's only thrown 58 pitches. He can go a mile. He can go 140. Definitely in this league, don't see a lot of pitchers get tired too quick. The pitch to A-Rod puts it on the ground to Evans. Evans in time to Fox. One away. Let's see what's going on with this Tommy Tucker. Brother of Tanya Tucker. 372 hitter. 1889 Baltimore player here. And MV must like this guy. I think MV's done his research. It's research. Let's see what we got. Here's the pitch to Tucker. Tucker sends this one into center field, rounds it, and Foster will get that into Johnson, and Tucker is aboard. Pitch from Alexander. Here's Chick Stahl. Cobb coming in on it, makes the catch. Tucker retreats to first. And we have two away for Ted Williams. And Williams draws a walk. Here is Josh Gibson. He's doubled and singled. Quite an opening day. Pitch from Alexander. Gibson hits this one hard right at Ruth. Makes the catch, and that will end the inning. So we're through four. 5-3 game. See if DeGrom settles down. We got Davey Johnson in here, the second baseman. Pitch, and he walks. So leadoff runner is aboard this inning, and here's Yadier Molina. Uh-oh, Gibson's going out, checking the signs with DeGrom. The pitch, Molina lines this one sharply in the left. Ooh, Beatles. You tell me, Beatles. Safe chance. We're going to send Johnson to third. Send him. All right. MV? No, we're not going to throw with the 29%. Or you tell me, MV. We'll keep him right there. Keeler steps in. Runners on the corner. No out. Wee Willie. Here's the pitch. Oh, a strikeout. Not something you see every day from Willie Keeler. Now we've got Ty Cobb stepping in. See, what year Cobb are we looking at here? 1907 Ty Cobb. The pitch, runners on the corners. Cobb lines this one down into the corner in right field. That'll get one run home. Stalls tracked it down, and looks like Cobb's headed for third, and here's the throw. He just beats it. So Cobb cleared him off with the triple, and we're tied up, folks. 5-5. Pop Lloyd hit that two-run homer in the first. The pitch, and he lines this one back up the middle to Mantle, who gets it, and Pop Lloyd's on first, one away. Key hit there, drives in the go-ahead run, and it's a 6-5 game. And MV, I'll be looking for you if you want to wave the, what do we call it? The pink hand of disgust or despair. The pink hand of despair, I'll call it. At any point, if you've seen enough of DeGrom. And here is Jimmy Fox. Pitch to Fox, and he walks. And that'll bring Ruth up. Two on, one down. And the pitch from DeGrom. Ruth hits this one into right field. This one is drifting back, and it is off the wall. Pop Lloyd scores. Fox is coming home. Got to keep Ruth there. I don't want to let Ruth get over to third. We got an 8-5 ball game, so I'm going to pause right here and see how long the signal takes to get to West Virginia or Wales. I don't know where MV, if it's he's in his summer home or where, but I'm going to wait a moment here and see if the pink hand comes up, because I think MV may want a change, or who knows, maybe he want to keep DeGrom in. This is definitely a fun league that you can see. Okay, it's okay. Follow the AI. Here we go. George Foster steps in. Ground ball. I haven't seen too many infield grounders yet. A-Rod over to first. Gets it. Ruth stays at second. And that's the second out of the inning. I'm going to pause here. DeGrom, he is red on the pitch count. So I can hit computer and see if the computer does something, but I don't know. MV says it's okay. I've play tested this 1,000 times. We're coming back. And DeGrom strikes him out. So another big inning. Manchester put 4 on the board in the third. This time Mudville puts 5 on the board, takes an 8-5 lead. And here we go. And Schmidt with the strikeout. So Pete Alexander looking to settle in. And here's Elmer Smith. 0 for 2 on the day. And he grounds it to Johnson over to Fox and in time for the second out. Joe Morgan struck out and he singled his last time up. And he drops a bunt down, of all things. And he's out. It says DeGrom has a bit left. No, we're not, John, although we have some dead ball players here. They're all mixed together. Here's the pitch from Johnson. And Johnson's aboard, and DeGrom's still in there. I'm using C. And there's a strikeout. I guess DeGrom does have a little something left. Here's Wee Willie Keeler. He's had two singles and a strikeout today. And Keeler sends this one out to center field. Mantle tracks it down and makes the out. Johnson back to first. And here's Cobb. Here's the pitch to Cobb. Cobb sends this one to Tucker. Tucker over to first, and he is out. And I guess DeGrom did have a little bit left. And here come the Red Bolts in the bottom of the six with the number 8 hitter, center fielder Mickey Mantle. And Mantle crushes this one. It'll stay in the park, though. Cobb tracks it down, and we have one away. The bottom of the six for Alex Rodriguez. Single to center, or left center, his first time out. Grounded out the last time. And Rodriguez sends this one out to center field. George Foster drifts over and makes the catch. I see what Beatles has done here. Foster, normally the left fielder, moves over to center to make room for Ruth in left, Cobb in right, and allows Wee Willie Keeler to DH. Smart move with the lineup for Mudville. The pitch to Tucker, and he puts it on the ground to Johnson over to Fox, and we're out of the inning. It says DeGrom has a sore arm, and I'm getting him out of here, MV. Well, who would you like to see? Hecker it is. Guy Hecker coming in. New pitcher. Here's Pop Lloyd, who's homered today. And he sends this one right back up the middle, and he's on board with a single. A lot of leadoff batters in these innings getting on. So a lot of offense here today in opening day. And here's Jimmy Fox. Hit a solo home run in the first inning. Singled and also walked. So he's 2 for 2 today. Here's the, throwing over to Lloyd, trying to keep him close. Here's the pitch to Fox. Fox on the ground. Schmidt makes the play. Over to second. Not in time to turn the double. So we've got one away. Fox safe at first. And here's Babe Ruth. Ruth has doubled his last time up. The pitch from Hecker. Grounds it up the middle. Morgan over to Rodriguez. Got one play at second. Ruth safe on the fielder's choice at first. And here's George Foster. 0 for 3 on the day. And he hits this one hard. Williams takes a couple steps back, makes the play. And here we are at the seventh inning stretch. And here we go. Pete Alexander still on the mound. Chick Stahl has had a single. He's 1-for-3 on the day. Stahl playing right field for the hometown Red Bolts. And he sends this out to right field. Ty Cobb makes the play. And we have one out. Ted Williams, he's walked twice. It's 0-for-1. Pitch from Alexander, and he sends this one right up the middle. Pop Loy with great range snags that one for the second out. So Josh Gibson's had quite a day. He's had a double and a single. Pete Alexander at 100 pitches now. He throws it to Gibson. That sounded hard hit, but it stays in the park. Ruth with the catch. Three away, and after seven, it's still 8-5 Mudville. Hecker over, makes a great play. Great range, gets the runner in time. Hecker, quite a story here, but he doesn't know. This is wrong screen. Let's pull up Hecker this way. Hecker, 1882 pick by MV with a .769 whip. Doesn't have a ton of, almost a halftime pitcher. But what? Look at that whip. Just a great pitcher for certain clutch situations. So nice little find by MV. So here's Davey Johnson, second baseman. Pitch, he puts this on the ground to A-Rod over to Tucker. And he's in time for the second out. Molina, 1-for-3. He grounded a single between third and short in the third inning. Here's the pitch from Hecker. And that one's pulled foul. One ball, two strike count to Molina. And he gets his second hit of the day. Looked like a single, but he stretched that one with some fast instincts into a double. And he slides in safe. So we've got two out, runner in scoring position. And here's Wee Willie Keeler. This is his fifth time up today. He's 2-for-4. And, ooh, Hecker with the intentional walk. Walks Keeler to set up a play at any base. And here's Ty Cobb. Triple. He's 1-for-4. Pitch to Cobb. Cobb puts this on the ground. A-Rod's got it. Easy play. Gets the force at second. That will end the inning. And Alexander still got some gas in the tank. He could pitch a whole game most times out. Here's Mike Schmidt. He singled his first time up. You remember that great play. He singled. Gibson went home and was thrown out by Babe Ruth. I think we've had a fly ball to right, pick the runner off first, and we've had Cobb threw out a runner going to third, and Ruth threw out a runner headed for home. So had some interesting plays today. Here's the pitch to Schmidt, and he hits this one all the way back. Ruth at the wall makes the catch, one down. Here's Elmer Smith, 0-for-3. And he sends this up the middle, and he's aboard with a hit. Joe Morgan. He bunted to the catcher last time up. Pitch from Alexander. And Morgan sends this one out into right field. Liner's caught by Cobb. Two away. Here's Mickey Mantle. Ooh, throwing over there to keep Smith close. Pitch to Mantle. Mantle pops this one up. I don't know if this is going to stay fair. Molina's chasing back. Oh, he can't make the play. It's in the stand, so it's an 0-2 count to Mickey Mantle. And Alexander strikes out Mantle to end the inning. And here we go. After eight, it's Mudville 8, Manchester 5. See if Mudville can add any insurance runs. Here's Pop Lloyd. He's had a hell of a day. He's 3-for-4 with a home run.
Strike three.
And Lloyd strikes out. So here's Jimmy Fox. He's also had a home run today. Pitch to Fox. And Fox lines this into left. He's aboard with a single. And that'll bring up Babe Ruth, who's had a double on the day. Pitch to Ruth. Back up the middle. Rodriguez to Morgan. Over to Tucker. And it's in time for the double play. And Manchester's down to his last bats. And here's the number 9 hitter, Alex Rodriguez. Not a bad number 9 hitter to have in your lineup, I have to say. Here's the pitch, and Rodriguez sends this one back. It's off the wall, and he's in the second with a double. And that'll bring in Tucker, who's 3-for-4 on the day, Tommy Tucker. Not a lot of power, but 3 singles. And here's the pitch from Alexander. And Tucker sends this one out to deep center. Foster makes the catch. Rodriguez will tag and hold. And that's one away for Chick Stahl. There's the pitch. And this is another one back to center. Foster makes that catch. Rodriguez holds again. So a couple of well-hit balls, but they stayed in the park out to deep center. And that brings up Ted Williams down to the last out for the home team Red Bolts. And here's the pitch to Williams. And Alexander comes through and strikes out Williams. And that ends the first game of the season. A lot of offense, 25 total hits, 13 runs, runners being thrown out. Interesting game. So let's take a look here. And I have a little bit of a, yeah, it was a great game. It's a fun game. I enjoy playing these games when it's neither of my team, you know, playing. It's kind of fun. Lets me appreciate some of these other lineups. So look on the day. You got 2 3-hit players over there with Pop Lloyd. I mean, that's got to be the player of the game. Pop Lloyd drove in 3, was 3-for-5. Pretty good game. Pitching? DeGrom, I don't know how you'd sum it up. DeGrom was not good. Rob, glad you could join us. See you down the road. I might be, when we do some more games, Beatles, Envy, who else this week's going to kick these off? But I think I'm going to do another game here from the April 10th section. Or maybe sim the rest of April 10th and pick a different game to play on the 11th so we can kind of move along. That's what I'm thinking. But yeah, DeGrom did not have his good stuff. Nobody had any plus or minus stuff, but he did not look good. MVP Pop Lloyd. Yeah, base running was terrible. You know, I don't know if I've seen that where people took off like that, and whew, that was tough. So let's take a look at where we're at. So here's my thoughts on how we can kind of move along. We pick that game to do. My thought right now is I'll play the rest of April 10th, which are autoplay these 4 games right here, and then I'll go to the 11th and pick one of these games to play? That sounds good. And then when I quit, I'll have played two games tonight on the channel, but we'll have two complete days of games done. And then I can just export the BBX files. And MV, I don't know if you heard, but Beatles and I, what we're going to do is I'm going to make sure that whenever I'm simming, I finish a day on the schedule completely. So for us, it would be April 10th and maybe the 11th tonight. Then when I export the BBX, I'm just going to call it April 10th, or I may put April 10 to 11, meaning there, here's the BBX for the games that were all played on those two dates. So it'll keep it kind of easy if we're just completing days. So let's go back. Where are we here? Here's the 10th. So I'm going to say play April 10th. So those are done. And now we can move, take a look at what happened here. Jersey beat North Sound. Let's take a look at the box score. Koufax gets a loss, and it does not bother MV. He sure doesn't want to see Koufax win 20, because that's the guy he traded away. But 6-1, Jersey, tough team. Put him on it. And let's see, pitching. John Clarkson pitched a gem here. Only gave up one earned run. Let's see, my game against Badlands. What do we have here? Here's the pitchers. Bob Gibson gave up two home runs. Wow. Six earned runs. Boy, this is unlike him, right? And they still get the win 8-6 against Teant, who gave up eight earned runs. Boy, that's not what you expect to see Gibson and Teant, both from 1968, going against each other. It's an 8-6 game. Al, Red Sox fan, glad you could join us, Al. This is our opening night. We just opening day. We did our April 10th game. Now we're doing April 11th. But yes, he traded the left arm of God for Juan Marichal. Arlington and Cleveland. Let's take a look at this box. Weedman went nothing. A three hitter by Brown. Three finger Brown threw a gem here for Cleveland on a 5-0 game. And let's take a look at Hawaii. And I know Rob said good night, and Rob just left, but here's the box. He lost a game to Hawaii 4-1. He had Silver King on the mound against Verlander. And that completes day one of our league. So let's go on into day two. Let me make sure I've got them on. Yeah, now we're going to day two, and I'm going to pick. Yeah, doing well, Al. Glad you could join us. Let's take a look and see who we might want to see. Do we want to see Hawaii and Cleveland, Lefty Grove and Baldwin? Do we want to see Arlington and Badlands, Jersey and North Sound? Or do we want to do, since we've got MV and Beatles here, do we do another Mudville Manchester game? I'm thinking we just do another Mudville Manchester game. I want to see Detroit. Yeah, I don't know if I want to see Detroit. Yeah, I said let's do Mudville and Manchester. I think. All right, so we're going to go human. Let's play it. Let's do another one. So here we go. Mudville Nines. Leon Day is number two, so that's the right person. It's getting us the right people here, which I always like to see. Computer lineup here for would be Greinke, and let's take a look at the rotation. That is the second pitcher out of the gate for MV. MV's got that new lineup he's playing with here. And here we go, folks. And I've got this stupid. Yeah, MV says, I want to pay him back. You bet. Let me get back over to my the arc image I want to use. We'll use this one. My Ebbets again here. So, again, we've got Wee Willie Keeler. Had a great game yesterday. This is a smart move that Beatles did in his exhibition games by figuring out how to get Keeler in at the DH position with some of the outfielders he had on his team. So here's Zach Greinke, Gold Glove on the mound. And here's Keeler leading things off. He got a hit last time leading the league off, but now he grounds out to Morgan, so we got one down. And here's Ty Cobb. Cobb's 1-for-5 on the young season. Here's a pitch from Greinke. Schmidt comes in on third, maybe expecting Cobb to bunt. This one's high down the right field line, and Stahl drifts over and makes the catch. We have two away. Here's Pop Loy. Went 3-for-5 in that opening game with three RBIs, hit a home run, was player of the game. I know Beatles loves having Pop Loy on his team, and seeing him lead the team to victory yesterday had to be a blast. So here's the pitch from Greinke. Grounder to Schmidt. Schmidt grabs it, fires over to Tucker at first, and that's the third out of the inning. So we'll see MV if he can pay him back. We've got Negro League star Leon Day here on the mound against Tommy Tucker. Tucker walks. And that'll bring up Chick Stahl. Ooh, he's throwing over. Day's trying to keep him close. Here's the pitch. And that's a strikeout. First out of the inning, and that brings up Ted Williams, who's batting third here, playing left field for the Red Bolts. Oh, throwing over. Day's worried about Tucker getting the lead and heading off to second. And here's the pitch. Williams pops this one up. It's like it's going to stay in the infield as Johnson gets under it. And Johnson makes the catch. And here's Josh Gibson, who was 2-for-4 yesterday. Still throwing over. Scared Tucker's going to take off. And the pitch. And Leon Day with a key strikeout gets him out of the inning. And after one, we got no runs, no hits, no errors on the board. There's Jimmy Fox, 3-for-4 yesterday. Pitch from Greinke. Fox lines this one past Morgan into center field, and he's aboard with a single. Brings up the great Bambino, Babe Ruth. And he drops a... What the heck was that? I've got to go back to a replay. Ruth squares to bunt. It's bunted in front of the plate. Gibson jumps it. Ruth just sack bunted Jimmy Fox. I got to take a moment here, folks, and gather my thought. I'm letting the hitting the computer, letting them do that, but wow. I don't know if I've ever seen Ruth drop a bunt, but hey, it got the runner into scoring position. So here's George Foster. And here's the pitch. Foster, Greinke with great range, gets it in time over to first for the out. That's two down. And here comes Darrell Evans, power-hitting third baseman. And he walks. We got two aboard now for Davey Johnson. The pitch from Greinke. And he gets the strikeout, so they're out of that inning. Up steps Mike Schmidt, the number 5 hitter, third baseman, Hall of Famer. Pitch from Leon Day, and he walks Schmidt on 4 straight pitches. Bringing up Elmer Smith. MV. Wouldn't mind having MV. I don't MV. Let me know if you're up for a little color. I could chat you in on Discord for a little color commentary here, like they do on TV when they talk to the manager during the game. I'd love to pick your brain on some of your strategy, because I know you've done a lot of mad scientist work on this lineup. Here's the pitch to Elmer Smith. Lines this one right back up the middle, all the way to Foster, who makes the catch in center field, and that's one down. Here's Joe Morgan. Morgan on the ground, Pop Lloyd over, gets it over to first. Is it in time? Just in time. Yeah, ping. Tell me when you're ready, MV, and I'll chat you on Discord and bing you. Ping you in, I guess, shall we say. Here's Mickey Mantle. And the pitch. And he walks it. So we got two aboard for Alex Rodriguez. And here is the pitch. And a strikeout. So Leon Day, two scoreless innings. And here's Zach Greinke coming to the plate with Yadier Molina, who was 2-for-4 yesterday, not known for his bat. Definitely a gold glove fielder for the Mudville Nines. And he strikes out, bringing up the top man in the order, Wee Willie Keeler. Let's take a look at Keeler here. 1897 Wee Willie, 424 hitter. Definitely see why Beatles wants that guy in the lineup. But that's just a great line. When you go Keeler, Cobb, Pop Lloyd, Jimmy Fox, Babe Ruth, that's five wonderful Hall of Famers with some strong bats right there at the top of the lineup. And here we go. The pitch to Keeler. And he sends this one out to right field. Stahl drifting over, makes the catch. Two down. And MV says he's ready. So let's bring in MV. And Beatles, give me a thumbs up if you're ready too. I'll bring both managers in. And we can hear from both managers. So let me figure out how I'm gonna do this. It's pretty easy. I don't know if Beatles is on Discord. Says he's offline.
Hey, Steve.
This is the real MV we're talking to here, huh?
Where's Beatles? Can you hear me all right?
I can hear you.
Great stuff.
This is great. So, yeah, it's fun. Here, you're the home manager here.
Yeah.
Give me some insight, because I think I watched a video. This lineup that you've got going on here, you've done a lot of research into that lineup.
Well, on my Sims, Guy Hecker obviously was dominant, wasn't he? He was winning 27 games, and then we had the penalty against him, so I had to rethink everything. But when I was drafting, I did draft with platoon in mind, role players in mind, like pinch hitters. If you look at my pinch hitters on the bench, it's specific, like Bob Hazel, Kenny Lofton, they're all set up properly. But the lineup, yeah, I had to mess it around, change it around a bit, because I think Cecil Fielder's weak against righties, but he's good against lefties. So I didn't want to risk him at first base. So I found Tucker. Tucker was always drafted with that in mind. So I just said, you know what, let me just play around with some lefty-righty stats. And Tucker was the winner in spring training. Yeah. He won the job. So hey. And then Stahl, the same Stahl as well. Diego, for whatever reason, doesn't hit well at Ebbets Field. So I had to sacrifice him and put in Stahl. But Chick Stahl has always performed whatever league we played, Ned McGreevy, or when we've played the season one of this one, he's always performed, whether it's in a squad role like a backup role, but he's got a starting job, you know. I think the Beatles was very lucky in inning number five, and with that line.
Well, you were maybe unlucky because maybe you had a couple runners nervous because it was opening day trying to take bases and got thrown out.
I was swearing at the screen. But, I mean, that lineup he's got, though, Babe Ruth, Willie Keeler, Ty Cobb, it's unfair.
Look at the first five hitters. I mean, these are premier.
I know. Isn't it great to see, I mean, the creations you made, Steve, with the Negro Leaguers. You know, Pop Lloyd has looked fantastic in spring training. You've seen Leon Day and the photos. You know, they really do come to life, you know. Really pleased with how you've done that. You know, hats off to you as well. You know, massive creativity that you've put into the cars and the ballparks and getting us all together with Beatles and Big Clue and everybody. Yeah, you know, I'm excited. I think my Manchester team are going to win the
all
league.
All right, let's see what they can do. Because are you happy with Greinke on the mound?
Yeah, you know how optimistic I am.
I know. Here's a pitch to Cobb. Let's see what can happen here. Oh, I thought you were out of the inning, but you aren't now. So they got Cobb on board. Look at this Pop Lloyd. He's 3-for-6 on the year. Had some power. Let's see what Greinke can do. Oh, they're throwing over. They're worried about that steal percentage, guaranteed. I don't know what you've instructed your team to do, but only you know that, MV. But here's the pitch to Pop Lloyd. Looks like Cobb. Oh, Cobb's. Looked like he was leaning that way, but the strikeout. So here's Leon Day, and here's the top of your order. This is the guy you were talking about, Tommy Tucker. Here's the pitch. Oh, up the middle. That gets through, and he's aboard.
Now, for some reason, my playback is just a little bit behind yours. So let me just catch up a second.
How much?
A second, like literally a second. I know that Tucker's at first base. It's like a second behind. So it's okay. All your words.
We have, look at Tucker. He's 4-for-6 on the year. I just wanted to see that. He had three singles in the game yesterday.
Yeah, he's awesome. Switch hitter as well. Awesome.
And they seem to, you know, he doesn't have a high percentage there, but it seems like they're always throwing over when he's on first. Here's the pitch.
He will steal.
Oh, there's a base hit for you out to Ruth. What'd you think of Babe Ruth throwing your runner out of the plate?
Oh, just ridiculous. It was A-Rod as well. Like, come on.
D-Scott's in the house. Hello, D-Scott.
Hello, D-Scott.
I got MV on here. He's the guest manager. Well, he's the home team here against Beatles, giving us some color commentary, telling us a little bit about his lineup that he went with here after all the extensive preseason testing. Ted Williams. Here's a pitch from Day, and he hits this one out to right field. Cobb's drifting back. Uh-oh, that's over his head. Folks, that one is gone. Hey, Jeff.
It's a Teddy ball game.
Teddy ball game opens the ball game up with a home run.
He's been underwhelming in spring training, actually. Very underwhelming.
Wow, and you'd think with his, you know, he's a high hitter, and he draws a lot of walks.
Yeah, it's not cutting it for me.
What about Josh Gibson? 2-for-5 on the year.
It's been phenomenal.
Preseason, he's done good?
He's been the best. A-Rod and him have been the best, too.
Interesting. So A-Rod is rewarded by batting ninth.
Well, there's a method to my madness.
Yes. Oh, Gibson sending this one out to left. Ruth's going to track it down, though. And makes the catch. You got one down. Yeah, when I look at your team, I'm thinking, you've got a balance throughout where you've got power up and down the lineup.
And speed.
And speed. And you've got Mantle's a switch. So against righties, you're in another switch. You've got basically six people that can turn around and bat left.
That's right.
Looks like you broke it down into three threes.
That's right. That's right. That's
three, exactly three, right. And three, right?
That's right. The power of three.
Interesting.
You're right.
Here's a pitch to Schmidt. And he strikes out.
Scott Howard, you're absolutely right. There's a method to my madness.
There's madness to that. There is. Here's Elmer Smith. Another one. Oh, a base hit for Smith. He's a boy. Another one of these guys that you put in there.
What do
you call it? Just a platoon type of a player, right? Makes sense to bring him in against righties.
That's right. I'm a student of Earl Weaver.
Joe Morgan, one of my favorite players. You've had him twice. I've always wanted to get him on my team. Here's the pitch. Morgan down to third. Evans with the force out at second. And we're through three. Well, we know no lead is safe in this league, don't we?
None.
None.
It's too tight. It's too tight.
These teams can just explode at any given moment. That's so right. What's been your experience with Greinke?
Greinke can actually lead the league. In the last time I did, he actually led the league in ERA.
Wow.
Yeah, well, that's the latest file I had.
Well, here is the pitch to Jimmy Fox. Fox lines it out to left, and Williams makes the grab. One down. Here's Babe Ruth. Bunted. Could you believe that he dropped he dropped a bunt to move Fox to second?
That's taking dead ball baseball too far.
Yeah. Here's the pitch. Oh, a strikeout. So Greinke's looking pretty good today. What'd you think of Beal? I don't know if you'd looked at Beal's outfield situation, but to create room.
He's smart.
He's moved Foster to get that bat into center because Keeler couldn't play center. I'm trying to think his maneuvers there. So Babe could play left or right. So he's got Keeler in that DH spot. So I know that he had spent some time in the preseason testing out how to get the right lineup in there, and I think he's done a good job.
He's been suspiciously quiet. So that tells me he's thinking deeply.
Here's the pitch to Foster, and he pops this one up down the third baseline. Probably going to stay in for Schmidt. And he'll make the catch. And we've got the third out of the inning. So here comes Beatles is laughing at you. He's like suspiciously quiet. Hey, don't sleep on Beatles. He's done a
– I know he has.
He's been doing his homework. He's got that lineup exactly where he's got these good batters in there.
First bat, definitely.
And here's Mickey Mantle. Pitch from Day. And lines out to Davey Johnson. One down. And here's your number nine batter, A-Rod, struck out his last time.
Well, he'll do something. Watch.
Prediction by the manager. He's feeling good. A-Rod's due.
I'm feeling A-Rod.
Oh, that's a... Did you just call a shot?
I did indeed.
Oh, my gosh.
I've only known two
people ever to call a shot. Babe Ruth in Chicago and MV at Ebbets Field. Wow.
Yeah, but if the game is he's got so much offense, he can come back at any time.
Yeah, it's true.
Anytime.
Tucker, 4-for-6 on the season.
Yep, he leads the league normally. He normally does pretty well.
Chick Stahl, another lefty bat that they got to face here. On the ground to Evans. Evans is up with it. In time, the Fox. We got a 4-0 game.
Yeah, it won't stay that way.
Yeah, I think if I look at Beatles' squad here, maybe these last three batters.
Well, yeah, but Darrell Evans has got 41 home runs.
Yeah.
He's still pretty good. I think he's just pitching that's going to be interesting.
Well, you know who else he's got on the bench? He's got Miguel Cabrera that can play third on the bench, too. Don't forget that.
It's an embarrassment of riches, it really is. It's unfair.
dropped that third strike, but throws him out. So we got one down for Davey Johnson. Gold glove at second base.
Some on my YouTube is normally in sync with Discord, but for some reason it's slightly out.
Here we go. Yadier Molina. With two down, he grounds it to Tucker. There's Tucker. That's the guy that you – it's funny. I heard you saying something about infielder of all things.
The 90 season is a seven. He's a seven. It's just against lefties. He had to be platooned. And then I looked at Tucker. He's good in both. In all the sims, he played really well. I thought, I can't, leave him out. Fielder has to go on the bench.
You did your testing. Uh-oh, here's Williams. This one's coming in. Cobb really covered some ground. caught that one in shallow right field for the first out. Here's Josh Gibson, 0 for 2 today. I know you were really sad to draw Josh Gibson in the Negro League, right?
Robbie passed him up. I couldn't believe it.
I couldn't believe it either. And then Robbie came back and passed up Satchel Paige, I think.
Yeah, because I was either going to Satchel or Josh. I wanted Josh, and I got him. I just couldn't believe it.
There's the walk. Wow.
There we go.
Two on board.
And I think that's the pitch that's going to be.
Molina's worried. He's worried. Uh-oh. Cobb's going to make that catch. Gets it back in time. Keeps Gibson at second, so we got two down for Joe Morgan.
This Joe Morgan walks a lot, but doesn't hit like the 75 Joe Morgan.
Yeah. Uh-oh, he's Beatles good. Is saying. Tell us who you want, Beatles.
Has the pink glove gone up already? Wow.
Well, I just looked over to my left and I saw that.
I love it. I'm loving the league already. Loving it. Can't wait to see everyone else get their go as well. I think you've got a bit of a sore throat, Steve, actually. Sounds like you've got a bit of a sore throat.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, allergies, I think. Pretty crazy. Yeah. Let's see who Beatles wants. What do we give him here, right? Is Cuellar one of my starters?
The starting pitcher.
Cuellar is one of your starters. Because he comes in when I call on starters. You got Rudy May, who's kind of your middle to long guy.
At this point, I will stay quiet. I know who I'd bring in.
Justin Bieber's brother, Shane. I got Beatles asking me a question, and I'm thinking to myself, let me see. How can I do this? Let me see if I can open the second iteration. I can. Look it up. Open the second iteration. Let's go take a look at what you got going on here, Beatles. Cuellar is not in your rotation. Great call.
Right. Funny. My phone is in time with you, but my YouTube on my laptop, on my gaming machine, isn't. Strange.
Cuellar it is. All right. See what happened there, MB.
Mike Cuellar.
Lefty.
He's got a 20. Yeah, but he's still got a 24% hit chance. That's still pretty good. Going in four.
Ooh. And Beatles isn't sitting around waiting. He brings in Cuellar, gets him out of the inning. So it's still 4-0 game. Here comes Lee Willie.
Yeah, fine. This is where Grinky's getting tired.
Oh, Wee Willie's on. Yeah, I noticed Grinky, he's just only around 100, right? He's not going to go.
Yeah. Deep. He's a modern day pitcher, so he's going to struggle a little bit. As did DeGrom.
Yeah.
But I have a solid bullpen.
Uh oh. Cobb sends this one out to Stahl. He makes the catch. We got one down. Pop Lloyd up. This is a scary guy, this Pop Lloyd.
Yeah, I don't like him.
he plays a great shortstop, and he can hit. Oh, and he does. He goes opposite field. Now you got... Oh, boy. Hey, is that a payback right there? Keeler went for third, and Williams threw him out. It looks like...
It's a bad base running again, like the first game.
Beatles is... He's waving a yellow hand. That's not the pink hand of despair. We'll see what that is. It's a different color.
That's what we're going to call it, the pink hand of despair.
Never mind. He says, never mind. Wow. So we've seen in both games two base runners where they went and got caught on their own.
Third.
And today, yeah, and those weren't decisions I made. Let's see.
No, no, no.
Frankie to Fox. Oh! Snap throw. He gets back safely. He's got a one ball. No strike count.
Pop Lloyd. Oh. That's some speed.
He makes the play. So here's Cuellar to face the bottom of your lineup, your eight hitter, Mickey Mantle.
I know it's crazy, isn't it?
No,
I look
but
at
no,
the
but you,
I think,
it's little games. You've got sets
yeah.
of three.
DeMorgan's the speed, Mantle's the hitter, Rodriguez has the extra power. That's how I set it up. Smith is just a little bit out of sync.
And look, he leads off the inning with a base hit for you.
Yeah, but he gets on base.
Here's Alex Rodriguez.
Come on, Alex.
Beals doesn't have the hand. Oh, A-Rod up the middle. Quick throw in by Foster to Lloyd, and Mantle's at second. A-Rod at first, and here comes Tommy Tucker. Tucker, the switch hitter, is moving over to bat righty against Cuellar.
Yeah.
And through the middle for a single, and ooh, Mantle. I thought, is he going to go and get thrown out again? He's a little gun shy. He's bases loaded.
Come on, get one across, at least one across.
Oh, it looks like the computer's bringing the corners in. Oh, that's a big strikeout. Big strikeout.
Stiles doesn't strike out often.
Beatles is waving the yellow hand.
Let him do his thing.
Yank Cuellar. This isn't the old Beatles. This isn't just happy-go-lucky. This is the Beatles that's in it to win it, this guy.
This is Beatles fired up.
He's fired up, yep. Tell us who's coming in. He might be going to a reliever now.
He's done a Sparky Anderson. Captain Hook.
He's Captain
Hook. It's great to see this. It's fantastic. There's some good pitchers to bring in, actually. But they're at least starters, though.
Yeah, he's really got Rudy May, because he's got Ellsworth and Casey.
Naturally, he's other than Joe Nathan, right? I can see
he's
that.
He's got Nathan and Chapman. He's got a true righty and a lefty reliever.
Bring them all. That's why I left my pitcher in yesterday, earlier on the first game. Because I didn't really want to waste my bullpen too early, but he's got a sore arm now. I hope he's not injured.
Yeah.
DeGrom.
Here we go. And here's Joe Nathan coming in. He throws heat. He's going to play for the double play. Oh!
Take your base.
It's nothing you hate worse than watching somebody walk in a run. Here's Josh Gibson.
Game.
Here's Josh Gibson. On the ground, Lloyd. Oh, if he could have got that before he walked in the run. It's like, come on.
Double play.
5-0. Granke's pitched a great game.
He does pitch well, but it's getting tired now. So now I'm hoping the AI yanks him shortly. I might yank him up again.
There's Foster. Hard hit. Mantle. Man. Looks like Mantle made that play just behind second base. He came covered a lot of ground, and here's Darrell Evans. 0-5 on the year. And there he goes. First hit. So Evans is aboard.
Come on, give me an easy out. Give me an easy out. This lineup's deadly.
I wonder what is Beatles' bench like? Oh my gosh, he's all right-handers, huh? That's how I was last year. I realized I only had like three left-handed hitters out of 30 on my roster. Davey Johnson. Here's the pitch from Greinke. Uh-oh. Gibson's worried about them getting crossed up. Ooh, pulled it foul. Greinke is at his magic number, 100.
Right. Pull him.
Yeah, he's out of the inning, so it looks like next inning we might have a new pitcher in there for him.
Yeah, that's good. Nice. I'm a couple of seconds behind you. Weird, on two screens.
Might as well let the seventh inning stretch play here. Mike Schmidt stepping up.
Aaron, let me hear ya. Hey, Aaron. Very well. Where's Robbie Watburn? I've not seen Robbie for a long time. He's gone.
Yeah, it's true. He's like, I was going to have to shoot a flare off or something like that. See if he was... Okay, here's the pitch from Nathan. This one's hit hard. Schmidt back to the wall. Roof makes the play, and that's one away. Elmer Smith up, your DH.
Yep.
And he singles into right, and he's aboard.
That's what Elmer does.
What is Nathan can go? He can go 25 pitches. These modern relievers, you can't get much out of them. Yadier Molina goes out. Has a little talk. And, ooh. That's your crowd booing something. They didn't like that call, but two down for Mickey Mantle. Joe Nathan steps in. Mantle hits this one high into right field. Cobb makes the play. Robbie found a girl and we never heard from him. D. Scott. Oh, my gosh.
So true.
Greinke looks to be tiring. So is this the move we make?
Yeah, this is the move. Take him out. It's time to go. Robbie must have bumped into Hilda Chester on the way into Evans.
Oh, I think I know who you're going to pull. Who you're going to bring in?
I've got quite a selection there. Actually, it's quite funny that I've got good natural relievers in there, but don't want to waste them just yet. But yeah, bring on. Let's see, K. Rod. So right. Inning early than I want him to be, but I'll bring him in.
And here's Francisco Rodriguez. So.
It's not always impressive, that's the funny thing. With a 5-0 lead, but then again, it's against Mudville. And these guys can hit.
And he's got Buddy Ruel as a backup catcher, too. I was just taking a look at his bench. He's got some good batters here with Cabrera, Judy Johnson, and Galarraga on the bench. Here's the pitch from Rodriguez. Oh, and we got Yadier Molina aboard here in the eighth inning. And Willie Keeler. Yeah.
This is what I was worried about.
Oh, pass ball, I think. Oh, no, wild pitch on Rodriguez. And here's Keeler. Two ball, two strike count. Keeler down to first. It's a dribbler. Tucker takes it himself. Molina goes to third, one away. And here comes Ty Cobb. Two for eight on the year. One for three today. And Cobb sends this one to the wall. And looks like Stahl makes a poor play at it. Cobb's into second. With a double, and Mudville's broken the ice, and I see a hand going up.
Beatles got his hand up. This is what I didn't want. Did not want Efrod to mess it up. That's what he does. Beatles' hand is up. No pink glove. Too late.
It's too late. Yeah. And here we go. Pop Lloyd. Team captain, I would probably venture to say. And he flies out to Mantle. That's two away for Jimmy Fox. I think this is the time that Beatles would be hoping for a home run. What's funny is, I don't know how many Francisco Rodriguez gave up six. In this situation, though, it's only showing a 2.3% chance on a home run.
High chance of a strikeout here.
Oh, he walks it.
Good Lord.
Now look at the home run chance. I think Mudville's probably hoping that Babe Ruth parks one over the right field side.
Jesus, what did not want.
Here's the pitch to Ruth. Uh-oh, Gibson's worried.
Yeah, he should be, because...
And
I might
he
have
walks
to
Ruth.
Him. Oh, my God, right.
And Rodriguez hand is red, tired.
Pink hand, please.
Do we want Rodriguez out?
Alley there. Get him out. Oh, field. I blow a 5-1 lead. Right. Okay, still 5-1, right?
Yes,
it is. Okay, let's bring in our specialist, please. John Hiller.
I was know him well as a kid in Detroit, John Hiller.
I never knew him. I never heard of him until the draft. Never heard of him at all. So it's a pleasant find.
George Foster. And here's the pitch from Hiller. Oh! Man! That was a big strikeout from Hiller.
That's what we need.
That was a tying run at the plate with a 52 home run guy up. That was a big one there.
He's my... Hiller from the Tigers. Never heard of him. You know, I know a little 70s baseball, but never heard of John Hiller. My closer.
I'm going to pause here for Beatles because I don't know if he's on a delay. That hand's... Beatles, what is it? That's a red hand. Look at that. It's a stop sign. Nathan looks tired. I knew that stop sign would be coming up, so I'm going to open it up and see who he's going to
so
bring
funny.
In.
Stop sign, that's brilliant.
That's even better than the hand of despair.
We've evolved. See, Al's a big fan. Al's recognizing Hiller as well.
Yeah. Oh, Rudy May. You betcha. Going back to a lefty, and here's Rudy May against A-Rod.
Come on, boys. Pat it up with A-Rod now. Come on, A-Rod. Another home run. Should I call the shot?
Right to Foster. You know, Foster, he's only got a 3 rage in center, but he hasn't played bad this series so far.
Go, A-Rod. Go.
Pitch. Oh, there's Tucker. You know, this Tucker guy. Let's take a look at this guy. Hey, here's Tucker is 6-for-9. He's batting .667.
He's awesome. He's awesome.
As your leadoff hitter.
He's like the poor man's, well, I wasn't going to say Willie Keeler type up because he's his own man, really. He's statistically in this league, he's okay.
Yep. Oh, Stahl pulls that one. I don't think Cobb's going to get to it. That's out into right field. And here's Stahl. Chick Stahl. Ooh, a walk.
Go on, Chickie.
Ted Williams hit a 3-run homer. He's the one that broke this game open for you. Said he had a quiet spring.
Yes, he did.
The pitch for May. Williams on the ground. Fox has it. Over to Lloyd. Not in time to get Williams at first, and that's two away for Josh Gibson.
It's so he's funny. Walked. I'm still behind you on the visuals. It's so glad I can listen to you. See what's going on. Come on, Red Bolts.
Here's the pitch. Oh! Struck out. Dang. Josh Gibson. Aaron Reed's like, yeah, I love this. Hey, glad you're here watching this, enjoying it, Aaron.
Making some noise. Aaron's the crowd making some noise.
It is. We got 11 people. We got 11 people watching the Shanks League tonight.
Oh, Beatles
says, stop. Tell us what you want, Beatles. He's put up 2 stop signs. It's both hands.
Okay, well, here's my last guy.
Who says this league doesn't matter? Look at this. Well, look at this managing we've got going on here.
I think Beetle's been hustling us.
Yeah. That's what he's been doing. He just increased his hit percentage chance. Nice
what
move.
What is his chances? 24%, right?
Yep. Oh!
I'll stay with Hiller. I'll stay with him.
Hiller's got good numbers. He strikes him out. And here's Davey Johnson. 24% chance to get a hit. I don't know if you want to sub. I'm going to pull up your bench, Beetle, so you can see. He's 24%. Ooh! Beatles has a couple of 30% folks on the bench here for Davey Johnson. Muddy Ruel, Hick Carpenter. I'm going to pause. I'm going to assume that a stop sign may be coming up for the... Let it ride. Let it ride. Oh! Dropped it, threw down, got that strikeout to count. So we are down now, two out here in the ninth inning for Yadier Molina. I'm going to wait and see if Beetle says if he wants to let it ride. Or
come on, Hiller.
Bring somebody else.
One more out, baby. One more out for the Red Bulls.
Oh, we've got some 30 percenters there. Waiting for Beatles here. We have drama.
Judy Johnson's on the bench.
Yeah. He's a great third baseman. Oh, there he goes.
And he's going for Judy Johnson.
He's calling for him. Yeah. Judy Johnson.
Come on, boys. Let's get the first one going. Come on, boys.
And here's the pitch. Oh, it's not over, folks. Judy Johnson draws the walk. We're back to the top of the lineup. With the on base.
Lord, quicker we see the back of Keeler and Cobb.
And Keeler out to left field, and Williams makes the catch. Oh,
that's
and
it
looks like opening day festivities, game one.
Yeah.
Manchester goes down at home. Game two, they redeem themselves.
That's it. I think you stumbled on a nice little formula here. Maybe like when we do the games.
Yeah,
maybe
two,
the day, move to the next day.
Yeah.
Beatles does two, then does the day, then it comes to me.
Yeah, interesting.
Nice.
Yeah, Rodriguez was a little scary, but Greinke did pitch a great game. He just can't go deep.
Yeah.
Day looked pretty good up until that 3-run homer. I mean, he looked good the first couple of innings.
It's really weird with the numbers because Francisco Rodriguez has good numbers, but he just doesn't perform. He'll do an inning really well, and that's it. Now, Red Sox fans saying goodbye, Steve. Yeah, take care, Al.
So here's what I'll do. I'll go to the scheduled league game. I will play the rest of these. We'll take a look at them, and then I'll zip up the BBXs and post them.
Talk to Beatles, I think. I don't think if Beatles doing one tonight or not. I can't because it's like 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
It's a public holiday here in the UK anyway because of the King Charles.
Oh, King, yeah. Well, here, God look at this. Looks like I got a win 4-3 over Des Moines. Jersey. Look at that. D. Scott. I don't know if D. Scott's still with us. North Sound gets its first win and ties up the series with Jersey 1-1. Let's take a look at that box score.
All right,
Frank
Tanana,
two pitchers. Wright goes a distance, and so does Tanana. Wright gets the win 7-0. Let's take a look at the batting there. Babe Herman getting in the
mix. D. Scott is here.
He is. There you go, D. Scott. Your team just won this game. Beat Tanana. Ernie Banks.
They got a good team.
Here's Robbie Wartburg. If anybody's seen him, might have to check the brothels around town.
Last time I saw him was leaving Ebbets with Hilda Chester. That's me. Poor Robbie. Robbie.
Arlington got some hits on this one, but lost this game to Badlands.
Who is Badlands?
Badlands is PQ.
PQ River.
PQ Ribber is having he's entertaining some guests, I think.
So, some Welsh people
next week. Yeah.
Some people from Wales, he did say.
And yeah, interesting game there.
Robbie is ringing Hilda's bell.
Oh boy,
poor Robbie
with Juan Soto leading off in DH here.
He leads the league in every sim I do. Every sim.
Soto,
yep, he's terrific. Al Rosen is amazing as well. He's always in the top 10. So Hawaii's going to be dangerous.
Look, he's got Lefty Grove. Look at that game, Lefty pitched.
Yeah. And Cleveland is a sleeping team.
Yes.
I think they're a dangerous team.
Did you see what I posted earlier when I did a replay and they won like by 15?
They are. Whatever's been done in the last week, they have really,
Now we'll be ready to pick up with the 12th and start there. So here's what we're going to do. Now, I don't know if you caught this, MV, but under the file that you all have, the one I posted today, I think that you can use, go in and check this box right here.
Which box?
This one right here, DH League
Rules.
Under rules, that was left unchecked, and it wasn't allowing the right lineups to come in. So I had to check this box. So Beatles was going to check his. So if you'd open up your file and check and make sure that that's checked, we should be ready to go.
With the file I've got at the moment, I know it's the right one. I was just going to ask, with the logos, I noticed, I put the stadiums in, but with the logos, I've noticed that some of them say corrupt. I don't know why. I don't know, everything's supposed to be JPG. I've got the league logo in there already, which is great.
Yep.
And I was able to get the pork chops, what are they called? Pork chop team? The team with pork chops in it anyway, or ribs in it. I could get that picture, but the rest say corrupt. I'm not sure if I'm doing something wrong. I downloaded everything together.
Have you seen... I'll show you the ones I have here.
Yeah, you did send them before, and like I said, some of them work, some of them don't. It just says incorrect format. We can come back to that.
Mine are all JPEG, which should work.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Because the logo works for the league, and all your photos work. Oh, I'll double check it again. I don't know what's going on there.
So here's what we'll do. When I go to export games, I'll click all these. It's basically two league days. And since I did April 10th and 11th, I'm going to...
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's not export. Oh, yeah, it is. I'm going to call it April 10 and 11.
Yeah.
That seems logical, right? And then that way we'll just name it for the actual month and the games we played that are listed on our baseball schedule.
Just to remind me again, we're exporting the game, aren't we? What have you exported?
Yeah, and usually it will export to the league.
Right, okay, fine.
So
okay, I just have to remember how to do that. So once I do it once, I'll be all right.
There you go. So I'll just have it go to league folder here.
Yeah.
April 10th. And then if I go to the league folder,
you'll see it.
Go here. Got all my other stuff I'm doing here. Seasons. And I know which one I'm using right here. And it should be April 10 and 11 BBX right here. Copy it. And I'm going to drop it in Discord.
Great stuff.
And I guess we should put it under Game Files BBX.
Yeah.
I'll call it Games from April 10 to 11.
It's the BBX, that's it, yeah.
And there it is.
Thank you very much.
Who knows where he is, Beatles? Yeah, we've got to... I don't know. Maybe there was mud wrestling or something going on? Not sure. Anyway, there's the standings.
Yeah. Good stuff.
After 2 days of baseball. So, hey, I don't know who's going to take it next, tomorrow, the next day, or whatever. But yeah, I think if we grab it and do a game from a day and sim that day and then do a game or whatever, we can kind of figure out what pace makes sense to not take all year to play the league.
Yeah, I can definitely do Thursday night because I'm off on Friday, and I can do Friday as well, Friday night. If Beatles was to do one tomorrow, it would be British time early, which I don't think suits anyone. But I can do one tomorrow afternoon British time. Most of that would be lunchtime your time.
Yep.
I don't know if you want me to do that. I'm quite happy to. But if Beatles wants to go next, that's great.
Yeah, and I'm happy to, if I could get a chance from work, to always tune into baseball. Yeah, sure. Never doing it. Look at the batting leaders through two games. You've got A-Rod at 500 and Tucker. Looks like that move. Tucker is your leadoff guy. Is pretty good.
Yeah, he's not bad, is
he? Look at Mudville. Not bad. Mudville's got four batters over 400.
They are dangerous. They are very dangerous.
Well, everybody, have a good evening. It was fun.
Yeah. Thanks, Steve.
Kicking
See you, everybody.
The league. And MV, have a great, I'd say night, but what time is it there?
It's 5:09. I'm about to go to bed.
So you're 7 hours ahead of me.
Yeah. Oh, wow. You're mountain time, right?
I'm mountain time. So it's 10:09 here. So, hey, all right. Have a good one. Good night, everybody. Yeah, and we'll see you down the road.